Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy with another in the series. As you know, I think I announced that my birthday was the 21st, so it's coming up. And to my surprise, Robin, my wife, went on eBay and she found something that was really, really special. And I hinted at it the other day, but I got it today. It is an NOS, a new old stock, original, unused Edison 1905 recorder in the original box. And I pulled this thing out and looked at it, and it is absolutely pristine. It is brand new, not a mark on it. Like it came out of the factory yesterday, just absolutely perfect. The stylus is really, really sharp. There's not a mark on the diaphragm. There's not a mark on the recorder at all. Nothing. A couple minor blemishes in the nickel, but remember, the thing's 108 years old. So what I thought I was going to do is I'm going to make a series of three recordings on a single cylinder. I'm going to make a brief recording with the original 1905 recorder, followed by the Canophonic recorder, followed by the Solo Cup recorder. And it's going to be really interesting to see how close my recorders have gotten to the original. I've never had a new recorder to experiment with, so I have no idea what they actually sound like making a new recording. So I'm going to install the NOS, the new old stock recorder, on the standard B. And I took a new dictaphone cylinder, shaved it, and trimmed it. So this is the very first recording on the cylinder as well. So I've tried to make these parameters as exact and precise as possible. So it's going to be really interesting to see how the Canophonic recorder and the Solo Cup recorder compare to an original 1905 brand new Edison 2-minute recorder. This recorder was not cheap. It was $200. But to find one is virtually impossible. And I thought it was money well spent. And even if it's only a run-of-the-mill standard Edison recorder, it's a new run-of-the-mill standard Edison recorder. Absolutely pristine, just absolutely brand new. It does not look like it's ever been out of this box, and it's never been used. There is not a single mark on this recorder. So it's going to be interesting to see what kind of recording it's going to make. So I've installed a newly shaved and trimmed Edifone cylinder. I'm going to be recording with the new speaking tube that I just made. And I'm only going to record for about 15 or 20 seconds. And then take this recorder off, put it back in its box, install the next one, 15 or 20 second recording, and then the Solo Cup recorder. So it's going to be really interesting to see how my recorders compare to an original Edison 2-minute recorder. So, it's kind of exciting to do this. I've never before had a new recorder to play with. I mean, I bought a lot of recorders on eBay and well used, but I've never even seen one in this condition. It's just absolutely perfect. So, I can only hope it will make a exceptionally good recording, and then we will see how the Canophonic voice recorder and the Solo Cup recorder compare. So just a quick recording with each one. Greetings and salutations. This is Benjamin the Victrola Guy making a test recording with an NOS Edison 2-minute recorder. Found this one on eBay. Robin bought it for me for my birthday. This is a brand new unused Edison 2-minute recorder. Looks like it was made yesterday. So we're just going to do a quick recording with this recorder, to compare it to the Canophonic voice recorder and then the Solo Cup recorder. So this is the NOS Edison 2-minute recorder. All right, stop the recorder there. Take this recorder out. It cranked out a tremendous amount of swarf, which goes to show this sapphire is sharp. And it's in the original box. Just absolutely amazing. All right, we'll put that one there. We'll grab the Canophonic voice recorder. Put it in position. And see where our stylus lines up. That might work right there. Greetings, this is test two. I am now recording with the Canophonic voice recorder. Going to be comparing this to the original Edison NOS recorder that I recorded with just a few seconds ago. And really curious to see how this is going to compare with an original 2-minute Edison recorder. So this is Benjamin recording with the Canophonic voice recorder to see how it compares to the original Edison NOS 2-minute recorder. All right. Take this one off. Put it back in its box. And now comes the interesting thing, the Solo Cup recorder. And it's going to be interesting to see which one of these actually makes the best recording. Or how my recorders compare to the original Edison 2-minute recorder. This is a definitive test. The only way to do a comparison is to record with the original recorder and then compare it to the recorders I've built and take it from there. And this is about as fair a test as I can think of. Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy, making a third test. Recording with the Solo Cup recorder. I recorded with the original Edison NOS. I recorded with the Canophonic voice recorder. I'm now recording with the Solo Cup recorder I built a couple days ago. This is made out of an original Edison body with a Solo Cup used as a diaphragm and a rubber band used as the gasket. So all told, this is going to be a very, very interesting experiment. Three different recordings, all on one cylinder. The Edison NOS, the Canophonic voice recorder, and the Solo Cup recorder. All right. So, this is the Solo Cup. We'll put it back in its box. We'll pull off the cylinder. You can see there's a lot of swarf on every recording. We'll grab the swarf brush. And this is actually kind of exciting to see how my recorders are going to compare to an original Edison recorder, or as original as you can get anyway. I mean, it looked like this recorder had never, ever been used. It looked absolutely pristine. Okay, so we have three recordings. The first one is with the original Edison NOS. The second one is with the Canophonic voice recorder. And the third one is with the Solo Cup recorder. So I'm going to put on a 14.5 inch witch's hat horn. I'm going to get out of the shop, a shot, and we're going to put on a Model C reproducer. And there'll be several seconds between the recordings. So it's going to be interesting to see exactly how this sounds. All right, here we go. The first one is the Edison Original 2-Minute Recorder, the NOS. The second one is the Canophonic Voice Recorder. And the third one is the Solo Cup Recorder. All recorded virtually exactly the same way. Okay, well, as far as I can tell, the Canophonic Voice Recorder was slightly louder and a bit clearer than the original Edison recorder. The Solo Cup recorder sounded a bit hollow compared to either one of them. But then again, it is made out of a Solo Cup. So I guess the only true test to do this correctly would probably be to reposition the camera and hook up a larger horn. So let me grab the El Cheapo Deluxo here. Let me get this chair out of the way. I think this would probably be a much better way to tell what this is going to sound like, as far as a true comparison of which recorder is actually the better. But it's obvious the recorders I'm building are at least as good as the Edison original recorder. So let's get this set up. And I'll move the camera back here. So we are looking at the horn. I think that should be a fair test. All right, we will play the cylinder again. Remember, the first one is the original Edison NOS. then the cacophonic voice recorder, and then the solo cup recorder.
Greetings and salutations. This is Benjamin the Victrola Guy making a test recording with an NOS Edison 2-minute recorder. Found this one on eBay. Robin bought it for me for my birthday. This is a brand new, unused Edison 2-minute recorder. Looks like it was made yesterday. So we're just going to do a quick recording with this recorder to compare it to the Cacophonic voice recorder and then the solo cup recorder. So this is the NOS Edison 2-minute recorder.
My recorders sounded better than the Edison original recorder. And not trying to brag, I'm just stating a fact that in my opinion they were both clearer and louder than the original Edison recorder. So obviously I am on the right track in building these recorders. To get my hands on the original Edison recorder was really interesting. Been looking and finally found one, and the thing is just absolutely pristine. It is absolutely brand new. And I'll see if I can't swing this viewfinder around, and perhaps I can get you a shot of what this recorder looks like. Now here's the recorder. Don't know how well you can see this or not. But it is absolutely pristine. The original glue, not a mark on the stylus, or not a mark on the diaphragm, except for the swarf that's all over it now from recording. But it is just absolutely pristine. It is in absolutely perfect condition, as is the box itself. Really, really first-rate condition. Where it has been, no one can say. But I paid a premium for it, $200. But it's something that I've been looking for, and it was the only way that I could think of to actually test in a true straight comparison my recorders to an original Edison 2-minute recorder. So, as I said, in my opinion, both of my recorders sound better than the original Edison. They're louder, they're crisper, they're clearer. They're also much, much cheaper and easier to make. Surprisingly enough, the solo cup recorder through that brass horn actually sounded quite good. And it's made out of a 5-ounce plastic cup and a rubber band. So, as I said, I'm obviously on the right track as far as building the Edison 2-minute recorder. So I just wanted to do a quick video of doing a comparison between all three recorders. And as I said, I've been looking for one of these 2-minute recorders for some time, and I finally found one. And as I said, it was a gift from Robin for my birthday. And so it's going to be really interesting to experiment with this and see how it goes. And I'll be doing lots and lots of recordings and basically just checking out this recorder and seeing what it's capable of. So in any case, if you have any questions or comments about the Edison 2-minute recorder, the solo cup recorder, the Canophonic voice recorder, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. Answer all of my email, try to answer it the day I get it. And in particular, if you have any comments about what you think as far as what sounds better, the original NOS 2-minute recorder, the Canophonic, or the Solo Cup, I'll leave the comments open on this video. Feel free to post a comment and let me know what you think. So again, any questions or comments, please feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.